Welcome back to my channel, Talkative Anjali. And here you see the prep of Pivri Dar, which is a Kori style dar. Today, actually, I'm cooking a Kori menu of Pivri Dar rice, Gawar Batata Bhaji, which I have shot before. And, excuse me. And, there will be also bhindi bhaji, which I had prepared some time ago. And I'm going to fry papads along with this meal. Let's begin. I have these red chilies, two red chilies. I have divided them into two. And then there are a few cloves of garlic, which I'm going to mash up and give the tadka for the dal. And our tadka usually goes in before the dal is added. We boil the tadka along with the dal. It is first, it is the tadka which is, given in the beginning of the cooking and not at the end. So, let's start. Putting in the saucepan, starting the gas. We will add oil. Kori's usually don't like ghee. Being non-veg eaters, they stick to oil, peanut oil. I usually use peanut oil, but this time I had to buy safflower oil because, lockdown. So allow the oil to heat up. Meanwhile, I'm going to grind this masala. So let me add salt into it because it's very little and it should be ground properly. About 1 teaspoon of salt goes in. Put this amount of dal. It's about 3/4 katori of dal. Let me grind this. Check. Okay, looks finely ground. So I'm going to remove this. Sorry, I'm giving you two blank screens in between, but can't help it. Okay, so the masala is ground. The oil has nicely become hot. Now I'm going to smash these with a pestle. Oil is smoking, so I'm going to add the lasun. Because I switch between languages, I'm always blabbering. So as soon as it turns reddish, you add the broken chilies, then you add the haldi and mustard seeds. So about 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds. Let them splutter and quarter teaspoon of haldi. Give it a shake. And now add the dal. We will need to water it down. We are not going to have such a thick dal. So we'll come back. Now I'm adding water to the dal. We Maharashtrians like our dal semi-thick in consistency. Now I'm going to use the ravi or the churner to break this dal. It will break as it boils, but I would like a better consistency, smooth consistency. So I will use the churner. So that's my churner going in. Just showing you how I'm doing it with one hand, but ideally I would like to do it with both the hands. Allow this to boil for 5 minutes, then the dal is done. Okay, I have churned the dal and you see the consistency now. It is semi-thick. It will boil down further and I am also adding the ground masala. So that is my ground masala. Smelling of cumin. This dal prominently has a flavor of cumin and garlic, and it's a great fun to mash in those, you know, tadkawala chilies, those red chilies into the dal and enjoy it while eating. Added that. Give it a stir. You know, a similar dal is made in Kerala and it's called dal curry. So the dal is boiling vigorously and it has got a lovely color, exactly the way I like it. Not very dark, not very light. A medium yellow, which is almost lemony. That is how the varan should look. And it is done. So I'm going to switch off the gas. And once I plate the thali, I will show it to you. This is how you eat the puri dal. You always squeeze out the, you know, tadka wali mirchi into your dal like that. There is another one I will show this. So pour the dal. See how it shows the copra, ground copra in it. Then squeeze the. And this, you know, fried chili in the tadka has a beautiful smoky flavor. It makes the dal even more delicious. Mix it and then eat. Spicy.